Hello everyone, welcome to the series of video lectures on operation management subject. Today in that I will discuss about the in module 3 capacity planning, in that determinants of effective capacity and steps involved in the capacity management. So previous session we discussed about the meaning of capacity and capacity planning, and capacity planning required different measurement of the capacity. See, the capacity is the ability of given system to produce output within specific time period. The total volume of output we require as output within a period of time, that we called as the capacity. And the capacity planning is a process of determining the production capacity needed within the organization by organization to meet changing demand for its products. That we called as the capacity planning. Also, we discuss about the measurement of the this capacity, that is utilization and effectiveness. So for that we required some determinants, that we called as the to improve the opportunities. The improvement to improve, one must know that what are the determinants, what are the factors that affect the capacity facilities. In that we have the first one, facilities. See, like how the facilities are designed and what is the layout. So those things have a big impact if the facility layout is not good. If there are a lot of non-value adding activities required, so because of the poor design of the layout, then what will have a big impact on the capacity, product and service factors. So the product, if it is difficult to manufacture, for example, if the variability is higher than the designed specifications, for example, if this is a requirement, so you have a lower limit and upper limit, and if the actual is always such that the variability, you can say it is so high. So that all the time these are some atoms which are below the lower value or lower limit. See, there are some atoms above the upper limit, so that will cause a lot of probably rework or scrap. See, but then already time has been wasted, the time and money has been wasted in creating those unusual useful products. So which has increased the adding activities, so that will impact the capacity process. So the factors, if there is not optimum, like it could be temperature, pressure, things like that, depending on what type of process you are looking at, or even the speed, if they are not optimized, that can bring down the capacity human factors. So things like skill and training, if a person is not trained to do that particular job properly, that will bring down the capacity. There could be policy factors, like a company may have a policy, company may have a policy that no subcontracting or no overtime. So related to overtime or even subcontracting, so company management may have some policies, and that could limit effective capacity. Then there could be a day-to-day operational factors like scheduling and things like that, supply chain factors, that we see in the last module, what is your supply chain factors. We see one by one these determinants. The facilities, just I told, it is referred to infrastructure, location, equipment, layout of workplace. So layout should be where the raw material is easily available. You have to select a layout of the organization. So for example, here we have the our surrounding. Number of sugar industries are there. Why? See, the raw material for a sugar factory is sugar cane. surrounding of this area we have a lot of sugar cane is available, that is raw material of sugar factory. So the owner will be plan the location that is nearer to the where the raw material is available. Also working areas, transportation facility given, all these go along when deciding effective capacity as against the installed capacity. Also the product and service factors. See, product range and design of service have a sufficient influence on capacity. These are the directly affects on the capacity. For example, when atoms are similar, the ability of system to produce those atoms is greater than when it's differ. Thus the restaurant that offers a limited range of food can usually prepare and serve meals at a faster rate than a restaurant will and give the menu to the customer. So generally speaking, the more informed the output, the more opportunities there are for standardization that will lead to the greater capacity. Okay, a third one you have the process factors. Say ability of manufacturing processes, that be quality products, that affects the capacity directly. Or in other words, we can say if a quality of output does not meet standards, the rate of output will be slowed by the need of inspection and rework activities. So the productivity also affects the capacity. The process improvements that will increase quality and productivity can result in increase the capacity. If we say the human factors, the most important factor it is the kind of task that lead to manufacturer of a job, the type of activities involved, the training and skill experience woman required to perform a job. So all have impact on the output directly. Also employee motivation, the environment, working environment inside the organization, this also plays most important role. If you want the maximum output from the workers, to maintain the friendly environment, these are all very basic relationships with capacity. Also we have the policy factors. See, management policies, you can say, directly affect the capacity in many ways. For allowing the second or third shifts, continue of the working for all three shifts. Also, the extending canteen facilities with minimum rates. If you say in MNC companies, some in Pune or Chakan or some areas, they give on food only for 2 rupees. Lunch they given for 2 rupees. Also they provide for tiffin to the employees. Allowing employees to perform for a very friendly environment. Also the operational factors. See, this means late deliveries, purchasing equipments, purchased materials and parts, and quality inspection and control procedures all have an impact on effective capacity. Also inventory storage of even one component can temporarily handling the some components. So inventory means storage of that all products. When the requirement of that product is there, then only you have to buy the that product to the market. Also capacity will depending on the supply chain factors. The supply chain management can have an important influence on capacity management. If the principles of supply chain management, we can say just in time, that we call as the JIT or Kanban process. So these two processes worked on the supply chain management. These are practiced, then capacity becomes very dynamic. The questions asked while with the supply chain would be what impact will the changes have on suppliers or distributors if the capacity is increased? Will the supply chain able to handle the increase alternatively, or if the capacity is decreased? So what impact will loss of business have on these elements if the supply chain? Okay, throughout the process from input to the output, maintaining a supply chain management is most crucial in the organization. Also, some external factors. See, the many external factors can affect the capacity effectively. Also, the expectation of product standards or the performance of the products by the customers can restrict the management options for increasing or using the capacity. Also, some pollution standards, you can say the pollution standards on products or on equipments can reduce the effective capacity. Also, too much paperwork that require for government regulatory agencies by engaging employees or maintaining some standards that we call as the ISO. Okay, some paperwork of the government that will be directly affects on the capacity. These are the external factors. Also, unions, a number of hours, union workers in union, you can say, number of hours or type of workers can employ may do it or may affect the capacity. Skilled labor is required, sometimes unskilled labors are required to operate the other products. So all these external factors will directly affects on the capacity planning. Okay, next we have some key decision to capacity planning that are related to the steps for capacity planning. The first one is estimate future capacity requirements. Okay, before commencing any capacity, the study of the impact of the working of the plant on the environment is studied thoroughly first. Then any project which is against that we have to decide with some standard peoples, okay, then go for the evaluating existing capacity. Okay, if a plant already exists, a correct assessment of capacity has to be done. Then the capacity measures can be different for different organizations. Now, identifying the alternatives. If the capacity is insufficient to meet the demand, we can extend the capacity or identify various other alternatives to modify capacity. See, conduct a financial analysis. So once the alternatives are modified, every alternate plan is tested for economical and technological feasibility. Okay, and assess key qualitative issues. Evaluating economical and technological feasibility of alternative capacity plans, then you have to select the best plan. Okay, select one the best alternative, then implement alternative chosen. At last, monitor the results. The best plan or plans are selected, then they are implementing the total. Okay, these are some steps involved in the capacity planning. Okay, now we'll stop here. Next class we'll see how to calculate this capacity. Okay, thank you everyone.